beautiful Sunday in New England. A little chilly, but it's perfect. Starts in the 50s and it goes up to 70, so it's awesome. Nice little week with some problems and everything, you know. We're all humans, but the good thing is in our weakness, he's strong, amen. So we're going to worship him no matter what the devil's throwing at us this morning, because he is worthy of our praises. Thank you, Lord. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound to save a wretch like me. For I was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Hallelujah. Christ is risen from the grave. Hallelujah. Christ is risen from the grave. Prodigal is welcome home, the sinners now are saved. For the God who died came back to life, and everything is changed. Hallelujah. Christ is risen from the grave. Hallelujah. Christ is risen from the grave. Oh, death, where is your sting? Oh, fear, where is your power? For the mighty King of Kings has disarmed you. Delivered and redeemed, eternal life resounds. Oh, praise his name forever. Hallelujah. Christ is risen. Sweet embrace, I'll see your scars, your open arms, and the beauty of your face. Through tears of joy I'll lift my voice in everlasting praise. Hallelujah. Christ is risen from the grave. And on the day you call me in to heaven's sweet embrace, I'll see your scars, your open arms, and the beauty of your face. Through tears of joy I lift my voice in everlasting praise. Hallelujah, Christ is risen from the grave. Thank God he is risen so that we can rise to it with him. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. He became sin, who knew no sin, that we might become his righteousness. He humbled himself and carried the cross. Love so
Jesus Messiah.
Thank you, Jesus. The name of above all names. Jealous for me, love's like a hurricane. I am a tree bending beneath the weight of his wind and mercy. When all of a sudden I'm unaware of these afflictions, keep by glory, and I realize just how beautiful you are and how great your affections are for me. Oh, how he loves us all. Oh, how he loves us. How he loves us all.
He loves us.
He loves us so much, amen. We just can't see it sometimes because we're human and we see things like human. Thank you, Lord. Scripture I want to share this morning. It is from John 14, starting on verse 12. It's truly, truly, I say to you, whoever believes in me will also do the works that I do, and greater works than this will he do, because I'm going to the Father. Whatever you ask in my name, this I will do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask me anything in my name, I will do it. And in many other places, Jesus says, go and proclaim healing, cleanse lepers, cast out demons. Everything you do, do it in my name. If you do it right, thinking how Jesus thinks, you're connected with him. As long as you speak his name, every demon, every power, every authority has to bow his knee to him. And they have to obey whatever he says. No demon can act without asking God to do so. And God only allows us to stretch you and make you stronger. So this morning we want to speak the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. What a beautiful name.
I just want to speak the name of Jesus over every heart and every mind, cause I know there is peace within your presence. I speak Jesus. I just want to speak the name of Jesus till every dark addiction starts to break, declaring there is hope and there is freedom. I speak Jesus. Your name is power. Your name is healing. Your name is life. Break every stronghold. Shine through the shadows. Burn like a fire. I just want to speak the name of Jesus over every fear and anxiety. Every soul have captive by depression. I speak Jesus. Your name is power. Your name is healing. Your name is life. Break every stronghold. Shine through the shadows. Jesus from the mountains, Jesus in the streets, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy, Jesus for my family, speak the holy name of Jesus. Shout Jesus from the mountains, Jesus in the street, Jesus in the darkness. Oh. for my family. I speak the holy name of Jesus. Your name is power. Your name is healing. Your name is life. Break every stronghold. Time through the shadow. Burn like a fire. Your name is power. Your name is healing. Your name is life. Break every stronghold. Shine through the shadow. Burn.
I just wanna speak the name of Jesus over fear and every anxiety, to every soul held captive by depression. I speak Jesus. I speak Jesus.
Shout Jesus from the mountains, Jesus in the streets, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy. Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name of Jesus. Shout Jesus from the mountains, Jesus in the streets, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy. Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name of Jesus. Shout Jesus from the mountains, Jesus in the streets, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy. Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name of Jesus.
Your name.
Thank you, Lord. Breakthrough, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Father, receive this worship, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Father, I pray this morning, Lord. I pray that you receive this worship that we have bring as an offering to you, Lord. Father, we want to thank you for this place. We want to thank you for another day that we can breathe and be healthy and come worship you and speak your name and declare it over our families, over the streets, over the mountains, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for being our Lord. Thank you for pointing out to us and loving us first so that we can look up to you, Lord.
Thank you for serving like you did Moses with the snake in the desert. That we can look up on that cross and know that we are healed from sin. That you have done the work that no one could do. Only your blood. The precious blood of Jesus. Father, we want to thank you this morning. And Father, I want to ask you that if there's anyone out there watching, Lord, that have not received you, that have not put their trust and faith in you, Lord, that you come into their hearts right now, Father, that you come and comfort them and allow them to listen to this message, Lord. You know who's watching out there and what they need, Lord. You know every stronghold and demon that's around them trying to hold them captive, trying to block this message from them. But like I said earlier, every knee has to bow to you, Lord, and I ask right now that you silence every demon so they can hear this, Lord, for their salvation, Father. And I want to tell you this morning, if you have not put your trust and faith in the name of Jesus, you can look around. You ain't got to go so far. This world is falling apart, and it's only getting worse and will continue to get worse. I know there's many pastors out there that are preaching prosperity and the world's going to get better and God is coming and everything's going to be beautiful. Yeah, after the destruction of this world, that will happen. Prosperity and life eternal with the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ. But right now in this world, destruction waits for you if you don't put your name in Jesus. Jesus says, I am the truth, the way, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. No one. It is only through Jesus. Why? Because he's the only one that denied himself as a God, made himself into flesh as a human, and came and died a punishment and died on that cross for you so that you don't have to pay the punishment eternal on hell that you deserve. And as easy as it sounds, you just accept them and you present that to the Father when you go to heaven and you enter. He is your sacrifice to show. He is your money to go in. The blood of Jesus. Nothing else can get you into those doors. And if you haven't put your faith in him right now, I'm going to lead you into a prayer for you to invite him to come live in your heart. The Holy Spirit of Jesus is here, and he's waiting for you to open your mouth and set your heart to him. And he will come into you and cleanse you and set you free. Is it going to be perfect? No. We're still here. We're still wrapping this flesh. But he died on the cross and resurrected so that if you die before the rapture, you can resurrect with him in the day of the resurrection. If not, there's another place to go that you don't even want to think about it. So I encourage you this morning, set your heart for it. And say, Father, come into my heart. Forgive me of my sins. Be my Lord and Savior from this moment forward. Put your Holy Spirit in me, Lord, and help me to live the rest of the days that I got left here on earth. Guide me, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. If you pray this, but believe it in your heart, that is the most important part. Because even if you can't speak, you can say it in your thoughts. He's going to hear you. And if your heart is right, he knows your heart better than you know yourself. And it is your heart that will become his home. And your body will become his temple. And just put your trust and faith in him. Nothing else matters. Anything you can get here, money, millions, billions, cars, everything is going to end up in destruction. You're not taking anything with you when you die. Nothing matters but the salvation of your soul, which is eternal life. It's the best place to go. He died for you, and now he wants to give you his entire kingdom for an eternity. Don't turn this down. There is no better offer. I know there's a big deception out there. A lot of people saying a lot of things, but the Bible has been standing from before technology, before all these lies. The Bible has been there, has never changed. Some people have tried to burn it. Some people have tried to change it. But the power of God still in that word. He stands in that word, and nothing can destroy it. And it is the same forever. Has never changed. Everything else has changed. Every generation has a new things coming out and new ways to live, but the word of God stands the same forever and ever. So trust it this morning. Father, thank you, Lord. Thank you for allowing me to do this, Lord. Thank you for guiding me. You know who's watching out there, Lord. Help them to believe in this, Lord. and come into their hearts, Lord. Comfort them, Father. Make it a little easier, Lord. Take the weight off their backs. Rebuke the demons that are around them in their lives in Jesus' name, Lord. And carry them into salvation, into your kingdom, Lord. Father, and we ask you that you move this morning, Lord. That you let our flesh get out of the way, clear our minds, cleanse our hearts, and help us to focus in the message you have this morning for us. Help us, Father. Let it be you in the pastor this morning speaking. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hallelujah. You know, you heard the word this morning from Brother Gabby, and, you know, there's a place that no one would choose to go to. You know, there's many people who say that they're going to go to hell because that's where all their friends are going to be. They have no idea what they're talking about. None. Zero. I hope that's not you if you're watching. You know, Brother Gabby asked for the Lord to move this morning, and he's already moved. He's already been speaking. He's already been touching our hearts, convicting and encouraging and transforming through worship and the word of salvation. This morning is Pentecost Sunday. It's the day that, you know, it's also Memorial Day weekend, and I was thinking this morning how we, Memorial Day, we remember, hallelujah, we remember the many sacrifices made for our great nation to become what it once was. And today is a day of memorial. It's a day that we remember what happened 50 days after the ascension of Jesus Christ, after the crucifixion of Jesus Christ. You know, when Jesus was crucified and rose from the dead, he was the first fruits and the first fruit of many brethren. He was the first to rise from the dead to go to the Father. And 50 days later, the church was birthed. The church came into existence. Are you a part of the family of God? Have you been adopted into the family? The Bible says that Jesus showed himself for 40 days. He showed himself to the disciples and many people. And he told them to go and wait in Jerusalem, to go wait until the gift of the Father, the promise, would be given. And that was the Holy Spirit. See, God created everything, and Jesus came to the world, died on a cross for the penalty of all of our sins, yours and mine. And then he rose from the dead. Listen, he died for our sin, but he rose from the dead for our righteousness. And then the third person of the Godhead, the third person of God, the Holy Spirit, came, and as the apostle, as the disciples were obedient to Jesus and they waited in that upper room, and the Bible says that the Holy Spirit came in. Acts chapter 2 verses 1 through 3 says, when the day of Pentecost arrived, they were all together in one place, and suddenly there came from heaven a sound like a mighty rushing wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. And divided tongues as of fire appeared to them and rested on each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. The church was birthed. The church was born. You know, it was born. The church came into existence because his disciples were obedient. The church was birthed from obedience. Hallelujah. They responded to what Jesus was telling them. Are you responding in your life today to what Jesus has told you, that as Brother Gabby had quoted this morning, that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, and no one is going to go to the Father except through him. Do you believe that? Are you responding to that? Have you responded to that? In obedience, the Holy Spirit came and met those people, those disciples, and filled each one of them. You know, the Bible says that they spoke in other tongues, in other languages. And there's many denominations. You know, I come from a Pentecostal background, and we make a big deal about the baptism of the Holy Spirit with the evidence of speaking in tongues. But the Bible says that in Acts chapter 1, verses 1-9, Jesus talking to his disciples, and it says, "So when they had come together, they asked him, 'Lord, will you at this time restore the kingdom of Israel?'" You see, they were thinking about this earth. They were thinking temporal. And Jesus said to them, "It is not for you to know the times and seasons that the Father has fixed by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth." And when he had said these things, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. The power of the Holy Spirit in your life and in my life and for all of you guys here today, this morning. The power of the Holy Spirit is not so you can speak in an unknown language. That's a byproduct of what he does inside of us. That's a result. The purpose for the Holy Spirit is so we can be his witnesses. So we can be witnesses. The Bible says that Peter, That very same day after it was empowered by the Holy Spirit, preached a message talking about the prophet Joel, and then going on to speak of King David. And just by declaring the gospel through the scriptures, 3,000 people got saved. He didn't speak in tongues to those people. He spoke the gospel. Why? Because he was being a witness of the word of God being true and manifesting in his life. He gave them the Lord Jesus Christ. This morning, on the day of Pentecost, I want to ask you this morning, are you living in the fulfillment? Are you living in the full power that the Holy Spirit has given to you? Are you being a good witness? I'm speaking to the brothers and sisters who are professing and confessing Christians, disciples, and followers of Jesus Christ. As the world gets darker and darker, as Brother Gabby said this morning, you don't have to look too far. Look in your school, look in your neighborhood, look in your local politics, look in your own family, maybe even look in your own household. The darkness is everywhere. And God is calling you and I to be a light. Listen, the Bible says that tongues of fire, divided tongues, separate tongues of fire were on each person. Now, we know that that's symbolic of the Holy Spirit. So he came individually for each person and gave each person a gift. Are you using your gift? He's called you. He's called all of us to be his witnesses. And every person got their own tongue of fire. And the gift of the Holy Spirit on your life might be to teach, to preach, to work with children, to do evangelism, to help the elderly, to do a prison ministry, to start a church, to help the homeless. Listen, God has empowered you with a tongue of fire. Jeremiah the prophet was so tired of being persecuted by his countrymen that he told God, "I'm not going to speak anymore in your name." But then he said, "But I can't help it. It's like a fire that is shut up in my bones, and I just can't help but speak in your name." Hallelujah. Now we don't only have the Holy Spirit that comes upon us, but he lives in you and through you and wants to touch and impact the lives around you. Will you let him do it? Will you live in the fullness of the gift of God that's in your life? The power of the Holy Spirit. The church was birthed on Pentecost. For 2,000 years, the church has been in existence. It didn't exist before Jesus. The church exists now. Paul writes in Romans that Jew and Gentile, two different people coming together to form one body called the church. God is inviting you this morning, if you haven't made the commitment to Christ, as Brother Gabby led us in the prayer this morning and gave you very clearly, there's only two places to go after this. And Jesus is coming soon to rapture his church out of here, and it's going to be hell on earth. But your day might come today, God forbid, but you might, you know, I know many people who have passed in their sleep, who got a diagnosis of cancer, and a year, literally 12 months later from the day they got diagnosed, they were gone. We look around with the opioid epidemic and people overdosing every day. Someone might not be there with that Narcan. Today's the day of salvation. And if you hear the Lord speaking to you this morning, don't harden your heart. Don't harden your heart, because tomorrow might not come. The gift of salvation is free. It's for everyone. All you have to do is receive it. And you can be part of this cosmic, eternal body called the church. You can become the part of the bride of Christ Jesus. And all of the blessings that he's offering his people can be yours. And if you do belong to the Lord already, my prayer for you is that you would be active in spreading the gospel of Jesus Christ to those who are in darkness. Be a light. Be a light starting in your home. You know, it doesn't matter if you're the light of the world, but the darkness of your own home. Don't tell everybody else about Jesus, but at home you're an absolute animal and a beast. Don't be that guy. Don't be that woman. Let God change and transform your heart. Listen, you might be saved, but God still wants to transform you. Your name might be written in the book of life, but you might have some addictions that God wants to set you free from. You might have anger, resentment, and bitterness that is leading you to outbursts of rage. And you might have a lust problem, a gambling problem. God wants to set you free, not just in the life to come, but here, now, today. Would you trust him this morning with your salvation and your freedom? The power of the Holy Spirit, hallelujah, that you might be a witness to who God is. He made you in his image, and the Holy Spirit gives us the empowerment to reflect the glory of God in the earth. I want to pray with you this morning. If you need Jesus, Brother Gabby already prayed that, but if you're a brother and sister in the faith and you're struggling with your faith, maybe you don't feel like you're living up to everything God has called you to do. Maybe someone's prophesied over you and you just feel like you're not meeting that expectation or that prophetic word. Maybe you know that there's things in your life that have a hold on you and you don't want to live like that anymore. You just want to be free. Listen, let the power of the Holy Spirit, just like in Pentecost, let the fire just come upon you, the fire of God, to burn away everything that is keeping you in bondage. All you have to do is believe, trust in the God of the universe, not in yourself. You can't do it. Believe me, I've tried. You cannot do it on your own. It is only by the power of the Holy Spirit, in the name above all names, the name of Jesus, and you can be free. So I want to pray with you and pray for you. All you have to do is just stand in agreement and believe and let the Lord do his work. Amen. Father, I thank you for this morning, Lord. And Lord, we thank you for the plan of salvation and the empowerment and the infilling of the Holy Spirit. We thank you, Father God, for the wonderful plan that you knew humanity would fall, but you prepared a way for us to come back to you, to be in right standing with you by the death, burial, and resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ. He is the way to you, and we believe that. But you've also given us of yourself by the power and presence of your Spirit. So, Holy Spirit, this moment, I pray that everybody watching and everybody here this morning, Lord, every struggle, Lord God, I believe that I've seen you do it in my life and in the life of many people. I believe what you've done in the Bible is still happening today because you are the same yesterday, today, and forever. You do not change. So, Lord God, we come to you in faith. And I declare, Lord God, over every person listening and watching this morning, Lord, Father, that addictions of cigarettes, addictions to marijuana, addictions to pornography, addictions to alcohol, Father, addictions to methamphetamines, addictions to pills, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I declare, Father, that those addictions be broken right now. Father, in the name above every name, the name of Jesus. Every demon of addiction has to be loosed off of them in Jesus' name. Father, I pray for those who are being tricked, deceived, and led astray by the spirit of this age, the spirit of sexual immorality. Father, of all sorts, I'm not going to just pick out one, but all sexual immorality. I come against that nasty, disgusting demon, the spirit of sexual immorality, Lord. I come against it in the name of Jesus, Lord, over everybody watching and listening. Those who are engaged in sexual immorality, you don't have to be in that bondage any longer. God has created you for his love, for his purpose, and he wants to purify you. Listen, you have not gone to the point of no return. Satan wants you to believe that you've gone too far, that you've slept with too many people, that too many things have happened in your life, that you're not worth being saved. That's a lie from the pit of hell. God will clean you. He will give you your purity. He will restore you. He will redeem you. He will bring you back into that place of healing and cleanliness if you just believe and allow, if you just give yourself back to the Lord and say, God, take my life, clean it and clear it up from all of the things of the past. Father, I pray for those right now struggling, Lord God, those who are struggling, Lord, with lust, those who are struggling with a spirit of sexual immorality, Father, sexual deviancy. Lord, I pray that they would be set free and that the demons and spirits of lust and sexual immorality will be broken off every single person, Lord God. Father, I pray for those who feel like they want to commit suicide. They feel like life is not worth living. Too much has happened. There's no hope for the future. I ask you, Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, to fill the minds and hearts of every person feeling like there's no hope. I pray that you would bring hope because you are the anchor for our souls. You bring hope to us. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus that you be the anchor for their souls this morning, Lord. Father, I pray that you would bring them, Lord God, to a place where they'll know they're loved, Father God, loved by you, the author of life. And Father, I pray for all of those who have been suffering with church hurt. Maybe they've been in a church and the pastor or somebody in the congregation, Lord, maybe something happened where they've become disillusioned, they've become disenchanted, they've become angry and bitter towards you because of some people that have hurt them in the body of Christ. I pray for healing in their souls, Lord God. I pray for healing in their hearts. I pray, Lord God, that they would not blame you for what some people have done. Bring healing and restoration in their hearts, O God. Restore them to their first love, I pray, Lord God. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Our email is on here. We keep putting it up with the subscribe. And if you want to reach out for prayer or you just need help with something, you don't have to be a brother or sister in the faith. Maybe you want to know more about the Bible. You want to know more about God before you make a commitment to him. Last week, at the end of my message, I didn't do a prayer of salvation. I told all of you to count the cost of what it means to follow Jesus because he's going to want you to change. He's going to transform you. He's going to want to do some things in your life. And you have to be willing to allow him to do that. So if you want to know more about the Bible, about God, about Jesus, about salvation, if you're somebody who is in the church, but you just don't have fellowship and you're just looking for a place that maybe will embrace you and love on you, then email us and someone will respond to you. And I just pray that God will continue to encourage you and continue to lead you and guide you all the way home with him. Amen. God bless you guys. Remnant Fellowship, 88 Rockdale Avenue, New Bedford. We're here Sundays at 10 a.m. God bless you guys. Be safe, be well, and we'll talk to you soon.